ninja walking is not only about walking silently, but it's more about walking in the persona of whatever disguise you're in. In order to walk stealthily, there are a couple things you need to do. One, maintain control by allowing your body weight to sink and be carried on deeply flexed knees. So if you're walking high up like this, okay, you're not going to be able to walk as quiet. Okay, so you need to get your knees flexed a little bit so you're walking knees flexed. Okay. Remember to breathe. Okay, so if you're trying to and you're holding your breath and you hear a creak, you might go, okay, so you need to be able to breathe. Okay. Stay alert to the entire scene. So if you're paying attention to how you're walking, okay, and you're not paying attention to what's going on, and there's a guard that's walking like this, and you're just walking. Be aware of your environment. Don't be so keyed on what your feet are doing. And maintain your weight on the leg that's rounded. Okay, you don't want to have your weight much on both feet at the same time. So when you do, you shift your weight entirely onto one leg before you start to move the other leg. And then you place the other leg. We'll go over how to place it. And then you shift your weight entirely there and then you lift this one. Particularly if you're in a dark environment, you let your hands float out in front of you. Okay? Because so let's say this is right here, this is a vase on the table. Okay? If I'm just walking like this and my body hits that vase, boop, that's more momentum that's going on. So what I want to do is I want to kind of have my hands in front of me so my hands might contact something before the full weight of my body does. That way I don't knock it off. If you make too much noise or you hear a sound or something, take a deep breath and let it out and sink your weight so that you're a little bit deeper. And kind of assess what's going on. If it was just a noise over there and you don't hear any more noise, then you're okay to wait a little while and proceed on. But if you heard a noise and all of a sudden everybody's yelling and screaming and running in your direction, yeah. Be as patient as possible. Okay, so in Japan, they actually made hallways that were too wide. Y'all ever done this as a kid? You put your feet on one side of the hallway, your back on the other side of the hallway, you scooch up the walls, okay? Or you put your hands like this and feet on one wall, and you scooch up the walls, and you can scoot sideways without touching the floor, okay? Well, they had hallways that were too wide to do that, and they intentionally made the boards to where they would make noise, very soft pressures. Okay, so if you have one of those type of floors, you would need to take a long time. It may take you 30 minutes, half an hour to get across just this easy. Okay, so you need to have patience. But also, you need to practice this so you have leg strength, okay, and balance. Because if you're trying to do that and your legs are quivering, you can get it. But if you do put a foot down and you get a creep, settle your foot back on the support leg because you haven't committed all of your weight to that one foot that's being placed down. Okay. Keep your movement appropriate for the surroundings. Okay, so you're 3 miles out in the woods away from the castle. You don't need to be doing this. Okay. Because there's noise in the forest. You can be quiet. You know, there's animals and somebody, you know, hear something, and if you hear something, you can just drop down and get on all fours and pretend like you're an animal stirring the grass or the leaves, okay? So, don't have to, you know, and if you've got if it's nighttime and there's, you know, a person that walks by every 2 or 3 minutes, you know, in the street, and people talking and looking out the windows, Shinobi Iru is about not drawing attention to yourself. Okay? Yoko Aruki is when you're doing sidestep. Okay? Notice how my feet are going parallel to each other. That's Yoko Aruki. Okay? My feet don't necessarily have to cross. Okay? Juji Aruki means cross, like that. Okay. So with Jujirugi, my feet cross like this. Okay. That's the difference. So if I had skis on my feet, and it would have to be magical so that it passed through my legs, the skis in for Jujirugi would still be parallel. For Yoko. For Jujirugi, they'd be crossed. Yoko Aruki, as far as the step, is this. You're crossing, going back. Crossing, going back. Crossing, going back. So, when would you do this? There's a wall. This is the wall right here. Okay? You want to go along the wall from one end to you want to be able to make sure you can observe in both directions. So you're looking that way and then turn back this way and look. Okay. And you can do this as a team. So you're responsible for looking back that way. I'm responsible for looking that way. Y'all are responsible for looking that way. So what we do, so right foot slowly crosses over the left. Left one comes over, right one goes, left one goes, okay? You see how that works? How we can look in all different directions and move against the wall, okay? Well, that's Yoko Aruki, stealth step, okay? So, deeply flexed knees. You have your weight on one side, comes out like this. Take your foot, up and then breathe forward and place the fourth toe down and then you let your down to your heel and then you roll your foot so that it's flat. Okay? Then once you've got your foot planted on the ground, shift your weight onto that foot and now the weight's off of the other foot. Lift it up quietly. Bring it in toward the other foot, and then toe down, roll your foot flat, shift your weight onto that foot. If you get a creep, then you kind of put the weight back on the other foot and wait for a second. So, okay.
It takes a lot of conditioning of your legs. And it's not easy on this surface because this one tends to squish and move back and forth. So it's easier to practice on a hard surface. But
shift, bring your foot in, close to your support leg, bring it out for any object, and then place the fourth toe down first, and then let the outside of your foot go down. Then you start to roll the bottom of your foot down. Once you've got it firmly down, you place your weight on top of it, and then slowly pull the other one up. Breathe in, sweep out, four toe down.
Nuki-ashi is kind of this sweeping stealth step. It's almost exactly the same thing you just did, but a little bit more emphasis on you're taking your foot and you're using it to move out to the side to make sure there's no obstacles that are there.
Okay.
Placing it down, putting your heel down, rolling your foot so that you got it firmly on, and then shift away, bring the back foot in. Turned out, and you've got walking on the edge of your foot like that, like this, and like that. Okay, but that's one version of Pet's Peg. The other one is kind of like a combat crawl, but you're here, your hands like this, and you're up on your toes. A lot of times in cartoons where somebody's on a roof, okay, and you've got a little bit of a slant, so they've got their hands and their feet like this. That's kind of a version of it. You'd be doing that kind of when you're going up a slant and trying to keep a low profile. Got maybe a castle. There's brush and stuff and woods out there. You want to kind of observe so you can have like a skin, an animal skin on. Alright? Here.
look over, and what do they see? They see something on four, all fours, with, looks like an animal skin. Oh, it's just a dog, or it's just a wolf. This one's really interesting, and if anybody says to you, if you're doing this somewhere else, and they say, this is the most quiet way that you can walk. And inside your head, you go, yeah, right. And don't say anything else. Because it has absolutely nothing to do with the quiet way to walk. Okay?
I don't know if I can do it. You put the hands underneath the balls of your feet, and you walk with your hands underneath.
So it's the most quiet way to walk. Does that seem like the most quiet way you can walk? No, it's not. Okay, this is where you start seeing how different ways of walking like a ninja are meant to kind of help you. Guys, so for this one, all this is meant to do is condition your legs so that you can walk up like this. Okay? Because this is how farmers walk when they're planting and simply weeding and such. Okay, so you're in a field. There are samurai guards. They may be talking about something important. So you're just kind of pretending like you're a farmer. Going along, but you see how you had a balance check there? Because it's just not used to doing this. Okay? You have to practice this. But you fall over and the cards go. Okay? So you have to practice. So it's just a way of teaching you how to condition your legs so that you can walk from a squatted position. So you're just kind of walking up and you're planting and you're overhearing the guards talking about a secret mission that they shouldn't be talking about. Low. Yohimi is serpent moving. This is combat call. Generic combat crawl. Okay? So you're flat down like this, one side and one. So, karasu aruki, crow walking or side walking. Okay? This is to impersonate. An older person or someone who makeup had a stroke. So you let your arm kind of like this. So you're bent at the elbow, you're bent at the wrist, and you put your fingers curled up like this. So you've seen people that have had a stroke, they have a stroke on the right side, their left side is going to be jacked up. So they're not going to be able to move their left leg very well, so they kind of drag their left leg. Maybe like walking like an old man as well, you know? Slope is oftentimes muddy, slippery. you may have a rock that's kind of up there that doesn't have any mud or anything on it, but it's just a little bit too farther away than just a normal step. Okay? So you have to reach for the rock in order to get. Okay? So Owashi is about learning about keeping your balance. Okay? This is one of the ones where they train this kind of stuff on ice in geta. Do you know what the geta are? No? It's a...
Have you seen Samurai Jack?
No,
the shoes of Samurai Jack cross.
Okay, it's got two boards up like this and then a flat and you stand on that. Okay, that's geta. They're hard to walk on. So in Japan, they would get on frozen over ponds and they would do all of their taijutsu and their kihon hapo and everything on geta while they're, you know, standing on ice. Do these big steps. It's about controlling your balance and your weight while you're taking a big step. Alright, Sugumi Aruki is kind of like Ino Aruki. So you're down here on all fours, but you're searching your head with one hand. Step the other foot forward, search your head with the other hand. Back legs go and then the front legs go. So you're here like this.